This is Saurav, and you're listening to my favorite talk show, The Weekly Show with Aditya.
This is episode 149, the final episode of 2019 on the 30th of December 2019. In a world which is slowly slipping away from the hands of humans, as a human collective, we are more than happy to hand over tasks which always felt degrading in the hands of human beings. And in this context, e-waste becomes an important subject to talk about. But e-waste depends from individual to individual. On one hand, we say that we should upgrade our technology, we should have new devices the moment they come into the market so that we can be in tune with the latest technology. But this is where the dilemma lies. Should we, every time there is a new technology in the market in terms of devices or other such products, do we need to change them? Do we need to buy new products? One of the reasons we talk about e-waste is because, just like humans, even these devices age, they slow down. Like the cycle of a human race, they eventually die. But unlike humans, who are either buried or cremated and are sent back to the natural environment, the same cannot be done with the digital devices. And therefore, the topic of e-waste becomes so important for some individuals. Most electronics goods majors, including Croma, Sony and LG, are of the view that Indian consumers are hesitant to part with their aging devices, especially phones that are said to become one of the largest contributors to e-waste. Does one really need to change their phones, or specifically smartphones, every time there is a new device in the market, or the companies are giving promotions and encouraging us to change one's phones? Let's not make this hesitancy to part with one's devices a kind of a criminal act and say that these individuals contribute to e-waste. Let this buying and selling of old or new mobile phones be a personal decision. Not everything is a global epidemic or a global challenge. For example, if an individual's phone is over 5 years old but it's functioning well, then why do we need to change it? Why do we need to go through the same tedious process of changing the phones, uploading the contacts, once again adding the email IDs and other applications? Let's understand, how do devices age? If we overuse our devices, they will slow down. But if we have the wherewithal to use our devices in a smart manner, for example, don't charge just because your battery level is at 70%. Charge when your battery level falls below 40%. That way the battery will last long and so will your device as a whole. There is another unsubstantiated rumor that the phone companies deliberately slow down the phone so that these individuals are compelled to buy a new phone of the same company. Buying such devices is not a straightforward process. One has to look at a lot of factors. If we need this device, if we have the budget to buy this device, or can we wait a few years till we can afford this device in terms of need and the cost? It's the same question with one's other apparels, like furniture, clothing, shoes and other such non-electronic products. All this has to be a very judicious decision and not one to be taken in haste. The counter to this will be that the moment the devices slow down, they consume more energy when we charge our phone or when we make calls, and therefore the radiation emitting from this even becomes more dangerous. But that cannot be the only reason to change a device. We cannot just gets so affected by this climate change craze that has been happening for so many years that we just get up, walk out and just change our device because that's the need there is. This discussion on e-waste has to be a very balanced one. If one buys a new device, then what happens to the old one because one may not use it? And in a contemporary world where electronic devices are taking over every task, one cannot just shut down one device and have a new one and restart over again. There are more important things to do for a human being than buy a new phone and put in all the applications and restart everything all over again. It's not even the question of being emotionally attached or clinging to something. It's about a logical decision. Unlike a human being, one cannot cremate or bury these devices because the fear of contamination looms high. So why not just carry on with these devices which have been there for so long, and one can focus on more important things than rebooting one's new devices again and again. And this concern about e-waste coming from electronic majors is obviously not genuine. They want people to buy their new devices, though they will start this rumor about old devices contributing to e-waste, or the fact that Indians do not part with their aging or old devices. Actually, this communication device is what it was supposed to be, for calls and texts, and just because one has added the extra idea of application and using it for so many purposes such as watching videos or using multiple applications, the device will slow down. So the solution is, don't have too many applications on one's phone, just have the applications that are needed and one's device will never slow down. Just like for humans, one talks about balanced diet, one reiterates that consume things in moderation. The same is the way with your mobile devices or any application. Use it stringently and smartly. Do not overload it with too many apps, and one may not worry about changing the device and going through the same tedious process every 2 to 3 years. Just because one can afford it doesn't mean that one has to buy it. It's not just electronic waste, even human waste is considered polluting for the environment. And when such preposterous ideas come from whom we consider as intellectuals, then one wonders, where is the world going? Are we even thinking, or are we so hackneyed about this phenomena called climate change or pollution that we just have to make or label everything as a waste? Hypocrisy of human nature is seen in this context when one reads or hears that one has to move from more traditional and outdated methods of communication and move on to more modern and sophisticated methods of communication, which means the maximum use of electronic devices. Not about e-waste or human waste being a major pollutant or major irritant to the environment. It's about the time wasted by such individuals who see themselves as monarchs whose sole duty is to lead the human race into more sophisticated and digital times. If the worry is about e-waste, then it's up to these major electronic goods companies to make sure that the main material of the phone and the battery is such that it does not contribute to the environment in a negative fashion, yet the phone lasts long. Let the decision to buy a new product, be it electronic or non-electronic, rest on the needs of an individual and let them decide if they need such products depending upon the multiple factors that surround this decision. If it is a question of being aware, then we all know that there is some kind of a problem with the human race and it will continue to exist. Irony is that the very goods, the very products that we considered as a handy product 30 years ago, now we see the same thing as an evil. It's best to leave such trivial decision making to humans and not influence them to buy newer, fresher products through the garb of e-waste. Humans by nature were always lethargic. We always needed someone to do our work for us, even the most pettiest and trivial of things. But in the contemporary times where human to human interaction is becoming a dying art or is turning into a specialized one, being tech savvy is the way forward. But it has come to such an extent that one feels almost aimed at the increasing propensity of human lethargicness. And by giving us this hazy picture of futuristic smart homes where one day everything will be controlled by an artificial intelligence, where all we need to do is give voice commands. The question on the understanding of how mature humans have become or how lazy we have become over the years. The introduction of voice command assistance is becoming a rage. And now the question looms, are we going the Star Trek way? Or are we worried about the rise of machines as one saw in the movie Terminator, which was envisaged over 35 years ago? Are we becoming so lethargic that one doesn't need to move from their chair and just give voice commands? Though there is a twist to this tale. There are two sides to this voice command system. On one hand, we can now focus on more productive tasks instead of worrying about the most menial of tasks. In a way, technology has its pros, but not up to an extent where humans become obsolete. While the likes of washing machines, dishwashers are efficient than the humans doing this task itself, but do we need to go to such an extent that one cannot even switch on and switch off the lights or any other gadget by our own two hands? Since these voice assistants and futuristic smart devices are all about voice commands, what if one's voice were to change or one had a sore throat? Then these devices would not be able to recognize our voice. What if these electronic systems, these voice command systems malfunction, there is a short circuit, there is a power cut, and the entire home system goes offline? Then as individuals, one will be left helpless. Example of TV fictional show Star Trek is there for all to see. Set in a time where everything is controlled by computers, even the most minutest of human interaction is seen as something great. Star Trek The Next Generation series, the android Data, is seen as someone who wants to understand human emotions, wants to understand how humans interact, how they have humor, how they are emotional, how the nostalgia comes. And this Data or this android is so overwhelmed logic that one sees that it's difficult to interact with this particular robotic technology in terms of basic human conversations. 30 years later, with limited human interactions, or human interactions only through the virtual world, we are becoming more like this android Data. Failure to understand humor or being oversensitive about the minutest of things is what is the biggest human flaw in the past decade. Overdependence on technology will make it even worse. In fact, what we need to learn from TV shows like Star Trek and movies like Star Wars is the acceptance of people of all ages, gender, caste, creed, etc. A subtle way in which who is an alien, who is a native, what is one's gender is shown in these TV shows is there for everyone to see. One needs to look at Star Trek Beyond Technology. Technology was the forefront, the idea of everything that is Star Trek from the original series that had the communicators, the wireless devices which we call smartphones today. Idea of food replicators where all one had to do was give an order and the food would be created. One didn't even have to go through the tedious process of making food. That is through cutting the vegetables, boiling them and doing the entire menial task. The idea of transporters changed everything where one could transport from point A to point B as one's molecule would disintegrate and reintegrate at point A to point B. But Star Trek is not about technology, as so is not the actual human world. While self-driven vehicles or giving control to the computer or the artificial intelligence for the most menial of tasks, for the most simplest of tasks is what we strive for, one has to learn more than this if one is connecting everything to Star Trek. First, we need to rethink about the word smart, which we use as a prefix for devices. We are now in the Internet of Things communication era. It means that appliances like toasters, microwaves, refrigerators, and AC will communicate with humans. One technology I am looking forward to are the holograms or the virtual reality or the augmented reality. If one looks at holograms from the point of view of Star Trek, the holograms or the VR in Star Trek was about creating environments in which one wanted to be away from the burdening of technology. There is a presumption that with the advent of such high-tech technology, which includes the Internet of Things and others, life for humans in general will become faster, safer, flexible, and more convenient. Unfortunately, we are so blinded by these emerging technologies like 5G, Internet of Things, flying cars, robots in medicine, and others that we are not looking at the extreme end of the spectrum. These technologies are bound to fail or malfunction at one point in time, but we are not looking at this picture because we are clouded by the emergence of these technologies because they have never come like anything before. The idea of classical versus the modern versus the high-tech versus something so supreme where everything is in the control of electronic devices. We presume that these technologies will make us safer. One needs to contemplate the ethical implication of such machines and systems. The privacy that we yearn so much will go away in a jiffy if we adapt such technologies without thinking about the long-term implications. The accuracy of the data provided by such technologies will always be questionable. The best example of how a robot or a humanoid thinks is from the TV show The Small Wonder, where Vicky the robot, who is given instructions, follows them to the T without any thought on its own. It as a humanoid for a while struggled to interact with its human masters. Despite the show coming 35 years ago, where such ideas would have been preposterous, it showed what would be in the future. One presumes that a humanoid or a robot which is doing the work for us will take a couple of minutes to understand the instructions given and not follow it, literally leading to any kind of damage. Then we are in the wrong. Sometimes there is no harm in taking a break from technology, switching all devices and sitting in the dark for a while or reading books. And when I say books, I mean physical books, not e-readers. But the human gullibility of associating and linking everything with climate change is one flaw that needs to be corrected and needs to be looked at. One has seen in many movies when such artificial intelligence take full control of one's house or such faculties, then it's difficult to disconnect them. The perils of artificial intelligence are beautifully portrayed in the TV show Person of Interest, where we as humans have put in such algorithms and codified and given such instructions to the artificial intelligence that we will put all eggs in one basket. For example, if X is a threat and Y has similar features to X, and even if Y is not a threat, Y will become a threat in the algorithms of artificial intelligence. And this is what the Person of Interest TV show so beautifully encapsulates. One doesn't know what will happen in the next 10 years, but one as human beings knows that it's up to us to allow machines to take over or make sure that we do not become slaves, but we enslave them, because that is what machines are for, to be enslaved and not the other way around. We will find ourselves in relationship with robots as seen in the movie Her. Leave my listeners with this question. Gullibility that humans possess. Our confused state of mind, are we expecting humans to act like machines, that is, to be flawless, to be perfect, or are we treating machines like humans, as we want them to have all the emotions as humans one expects to live with machines in the near future? The fact that human-to-human interaction is now considered a bane. Are humans becoming like zombies? Thank you for listening to episode 149 on the 30th of December 2019, the last episode of 2019. Stay tuned for the record 150th episode, which will be coming to you live the 1st of January 2020.
This is Saurabh, and you're listening to my favorite talk show, The Weekly Show with...
Please send your valuable suggestions through your comments and audio recording to the email ID adityathewriter@gmail.com. You can also like and subscribe to my YouTube channel and Facebook page, and stay tuned for the next episode.